country weather-wise this time of year than this one right here, Tampa, Florida, and beautiful Raymond James Stadium. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup set to go here between the Los Angeles Rams and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in Week 9? This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
Ready.
Two and a throw right away. He'll dump that one off to Mitchell. Finding space at the 40. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball, let him do his thing, and they got it out to him on the left side, and he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
Now former six-round pick, it's Elijah Mitchell, and they're going to stop him right at the line. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
Get ready. Hey, go steal.
Looking to pass. Tua. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Good work on the scamper by Tuivasa-Vailoa. It's a first down.
Give him a little extra credit there. His head was cool as the play broke down. Didn't force a throw, and in the end, got to show off his athleticism with a nice gain to bring up a new set of downs.
And a loose football. But it looks like a Buccaneer was able to corral it. Yes, the Bucs have it. Tampa Bay keeps the possession.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. Well, this defense for the Rams, they were excellent in that win over the 49ers last week.
And that's not the half of it. They forced 7 turnovers in that game. And I know we always talk about turnovers coming in bunches once you force the first one. But 7? That seems almost impossible, but we watched it happen.
Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third. The Bucs at 2-6 now on the year. They were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset, being in the right frame of mind in the best way.
And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Elijah Mitchell. His third rushing touchdown of the year. And the Buccaneers will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Taken from about the 12. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. Prescott flush to his right, and he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Now, these two teams, you may remember, battled in the NFC division round last year, and that
game was also here at Raymond James Stadium. The Rams ran out to a 27-3 lead before the Bucs and Tom Brady, they rallied all the way back. But in the end, former Buck Matt Gay hit the game winner at the gun, and the Rams advance 30-27. And he's going to have a Rams first down as he gets this up past the 30.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. They're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage. That's multiple times now he's tagged him with a big gain with his legs. Really showing off some nice awareness and the ability to correctly realize when he's got a chance to tuck it and go himself.
On first and 10, it's Gibson. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Meanwhile, Dak's throw complete there to Moore. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. A good pickup, 17 yards, and also a Rams first down. Pretty solid opening drive here, Charles. They've worked in the run game, the pass game, just steadily getting yards, and now they've got it inside the red zone here with an opportunity.
And the only thing they don't have so far is points. But the way that they're moving the ball now, that shouldn't take much longer. And they've established a great balance so far, running, passing, doing what they want on offense.
Throwing on second and 3, Prescott. Throw right side, taken in by Gibson. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got him the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Straight ahead, Gibson. He's going to get 4 out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second and 6 from the 10. Gibson again. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. Gibson is going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Well, solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment. That allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. So the same result, had he opted for the touchback.
Ready.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. So both of these teams, Charles, coming on touchdowns now. But this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Right back to Mitchell on second down. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. It's a 6-yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with third down coming up.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle, and off oftentimes we call them a hybrid. Combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
First down, here's Mitchell. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. Jimmy Moreland there on the stop.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Tua sets up to pass it. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. A shotgun handoff to Mitchell. 62 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
On second down and four, Tua. This is caught by Robinson. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A big play there on the catch and run, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs.
You have to ask the question, where was the help? Because it's a little surprising to me that he found that much room to run this close to the end zone. He doesn't quite get there, but he sets his guys up with a first and goal.
They'll run with Mitchell, and he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal. Once more with Mitchell. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Now Tua are going to try and sneak it. And I don't think he got there. No, they stop him right where it all started. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. For it, it's Mitchell. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Elijah Mitchell with his second touchdown of the game, 4th of the year. And the Buccaneers' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Gold with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. And they'll let that one go as it skips through the back of the end zone for a touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game. And they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they just had to watch that long, sustained drive, so we'll see if they can shake the rust off.
Yeah, and that's always a question that you have when you have to come off the bench after having sat there for a long time. Are you ready to go? Are you loosened up? But even more so, are you mentally alert and ready to put your best product out there?
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So line of scrimmage, still a 39 on second and 10. Now Prescott. That's into the hands of his tight end, Will Disley. Chiefs are an extra point away from evening this one up. Santos with the extra point, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession as they take over with exactly 1 minute to go here before intermission. Man open is Robinson. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. They run over center with Mitchell, and he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Throw left side complete to Troutman. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. From midfield, here's Tua. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. Touchdown! Deontay Johnson, a 24-yard touchdown. And the Bucs will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Gold able to tack on the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14. The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Off the play fake, Prescott. This one into the hands of Crowder downfield. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
He's going to look deep for more. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
That could have been a huge play, but give the defender credit. Stayed calm, stayed collected, and kept himself in a position to make a play on the ball without a penalty.
Play of the half, Prescott flushed out right. His throw incomplete. So we've hit halftime here in Tampa with a box out in front. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail here as we resume play. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
A give up the middle to Gibson. And good work there in open space. And he's got this all the way down now to the 32. Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just
going
to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. To throw is Prescott. That's out to the flat for Gibson. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Prescott looks to throw on first. And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Richie James from 21 yards away. And the Rams are an extra point away from drawing level. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and we are tied at 21. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown a moment ago.
And that shouldn't change the mindset a whole lot.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Walker. And the Rams are going to take possession of the football. So that changes things. You get the interception, and then to boot, a good return tacked on.
And really, it was down to him versus the quarterback on the return, and that's one you would think the defender would win. But a nice job there of seeing the play all the way to the end and making the tackle by the QB.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Richie James with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams have scored again in this third quarter, this time to move out in front. Santos with the extra point, and they will take a 7-point lead. Now, after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Dane Cruikshank. And the Rams are going to take possession of the football. Here's a give to Gibson. Down at the 25.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
secondary here on third down. On play action, Prescott. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, that's a good piece of quarterbacking right there, because he certainly felt the pressure coming. The alternative, getting sacked for the first time. He didn't like that option at all. Did a nice job saving yardage by throwing that one away.
So on comes Cairo Santos now for the field goal try. Right hash, 37-yard attempt. Santos' kick is up and through. So after four touchdowns in the game for this offense, this time they're forced into taking the three.
But you did mention four touchdowns, right? So four out of five, not too bad. I think that's a pretty good record for them.
This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Tua now on first down. And that was going to be off target and incomplete.
Partner, I think he's got to be careful as he continues to try to extend plays, because he's already been intercepted in this game. And the coverage, they continue to challenge all of his receivers downfield.
The second and 10 now as we roll along in the third quarter from Tampa. And the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. And that's going to leave them with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt them. We'll be back. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Here's Tua. Open man is the tight end, Troutman. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync. Stayed in great.
And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. He'll get this to his tight end, Troutman. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it. But in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. Tua now on first down. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield of man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays, just like that one we saw there.
To throw once more on 2nd and 10. Tua. Here's Johnson with a reception. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Thankfully for the offense, a fortuitous bounce there on the fumble goes out of bounds, because they're down here in the red zone. You don't want to lose one there.
You don't want to lose one, and the best part, because it went out of bounds, they retained possession, still have an opportunity to put points on the board.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. The quick throw knocked away, it's incomplete.
That's a really nice job there by the coverage, understanding that they're in a high-stakes situation. If he doesn't make a play on that ball, there's an excellent chance it ends up either as a touchdown or as a nice gain downfield. Right.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Tua to throw again. Complete. Smith has it. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line.
Tight. 97.
It'll be 1st and goal when we come back. chance to get right back into this football game.
Striker, 3-3.
Up the middle, here's Mitchell. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Elijah Mitchell, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Bucs have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Well, they move the ball down the field through the air, Charles, and then finally they get the running game involved, and it works to perfection. Touchdown.
And, partner, I kept waiting for that running game to come into play and actually saved it until the very end. Touchdown goes on the stat sheet, but you and I both know, and he knows as well, his teammates airing it out made this a successful drive.
Yeah, this play is not going to work. He's out of bounds, well shy of the goal line, and the try for two, unsuccessful. The lead cut to just four as they kick it away and turn things over to their D. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
A handoff for Gibson. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks. Prescott to throw it. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Shotgun handoff to Gibson. He will push his way down to about the 14. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake at the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at 6. Now, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. So decision time now, because a field goal keeps it a one-score game. What are you thinking?
Well, I'm looking at the down and distance, and that's where the issue comes in. It's not short enough that it's a no-brainer and you go for it. You have to analyze this one. To me, you take the field goal, take the points. I don't think you want to risk coming away with nothing.
Now, this was still going to be a one-score game either way, but still, that's a potentially harmful miss here in the fourth.
It certainly is, because if you consider that now if they give up a touchdown, they give up the lead. So he might be getting the side eye, but the defender's coming out on the field now as he goes back to the bench after that miss.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Their defense was able to hold serve, albeit with a little help from that missed field goal as they settle in now first and 10.
Let's go now. 43 rail. Green jack. Cut, cut.
Throwing again on second down. Tua on a huge mistake late. It's intercepted. Picked
Santos. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25.
Down.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
Here we go.
On first down, Tagovailoa. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Under pressure, they got him again. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Meanwhile, this one knocked down in the backfield. It's incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
Ready.
Fourth down, fourth quarter. Here's Tua. Escaping the pressure right. And this will be caught at the 30. And he's going to have the Bucs first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Whether it's a touchdown or a field goal, whatever it is, they need to score quickly here on first down. Tagovailoa. This is Smith with a grab. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Here's Tua. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Dane Cruikshank. And the Rams are going to take possession here at their own 6-yard line. Throwing here, Prescott. He's going to look deep for more. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And the Bucs are going to take possession of the football. Now with that interception, you feel like we've got a ball game again. Remember, 2-score contest and still time left here in the fourth.
And in the old days, not too long gone either, throwing the ball here would have been an absolute no-no. But the way the game's played now, throwing it makes sense. You just have to be careful when you put it in the air.
Set, ready. Ready.
2-and-a-throw. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts.
Ready.
As they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game.
Blaster, sit. Eat old blue. Spike blue. Red, cycle. Cut, cut.
Tua. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Dane Cruikshank. And the Rams are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. Charles, are you kidding me? 4 interceptions? I mean, that's a good season for a lot of defensive backs.
A lot of reason